Good morning students. Today we are going to learn about trigonometry, a new chapter in class 9, and specifically we will study about trigonometrical ratios in from this big topic. Okay, so first of all you can see that TRI I have rounded up. What does that mean? These three words, these three letters mean three. Next thing is GON. This means angles. And the third part is metri. Specifically, it is coming from metron, the word metron, which means measurement, okay, or measure, you can say. So this is the study of angles, three angles. That means we have three angles in a triangle. So there the measurement of those angles with their sides, the study of the sides and the angles, okay. We will study about that thing in trigonometry. Now, for to know trigonometry, we must have a right-angled triangle. Okay? Right-angled triangle. Right-angled triangle means, you know from your previous classes that it must have one angle 90 degree and the second and the third angle will be acute angles. Correct? So this angle, this kind of triangle, right angled triangle, must be there to know about this chapter. So now we are going to study or start chapter number 17 of your book, which is about trigonometrical ratios. So for that, we will need one right angled triangle. Obviously, I have drawn here two triangles so that you can understand wherever the triangle, whatever looks, it must have one right angle. See, I have pointed here two places. Clear? So now name it. Suppose this one is ABC and this one is PQR. Okay, now the side opposite to right angle is known as hypotenuse. Okay, I guess this one is also known to you. So in this triangle, which one will be the hypotenuse? This one. Okay, now we must have one of these two angles. Okay, these two are acute angles and here these two. Okay, so in the first case, any one angle you take, I am taking this one as the acute one. Okay, and here I am taking this one. So any one case may happen, any one acute angle we have to take. Now we will write it as theta. Okay, how to write it? See there again, this. Okay, so the side, this side is known as adjacent. And since this is opposite to this angle, so we will name it as opposite. Similarly, for this one will be adjacent. And this one will be opposite. Clear? Again, we can give another names also. Suppose this one as the base. According to this acute angle, we will name it as base. And according to this acute angle itself, we will name it as height. Either you name it by adjacent opposite or you name it by base height. Similarly, here also we will find this one as base and this one as height. Okay. Now, moving on to our specific topic about ratios. Okay. Here, six type of ratios you will see. First three, these three are basics and this can be derived from these three. Okay, these are the basics. What is it? Start from the first one. Look at the first one, sine. Sine theta. This is the full name of sine and we will write it like this. And obviously you will write the first letter as the small letter, not capital. Clear? For each and every case. Okay. Sine theta, what is this ratio? This means height by hypotenuse. This is the relation with this angle and these two sides. Clear? Angle and sides of one triangle. Clear? Cosine, we will write it as cos theta. See, small c. Here it will be the formula for this one. I mean formula or ratio you can say. This one is base by hypotenuse. Third one is tangent. Tangent is the full name. We will write it as tan theta. This is equal to height by base. Clear? So now look at the triangles. Sine theta. Sine theta's value will be height by hypotenuse. Not this one. This one. Height by hypotenuse. Cos theta's value will be base by hypotenuse. Tan theta will be height by base according to this theta. Okay. But whenever it is there, here, upside. So according to that, height by hypotenuse, base by hypotenuse, cos theta. And tan theta will be height by base. Clear? So wherever this theta lie, accordingly we will mention the adjacent or base and opposite or height. Clear? Now we will move to this one, cosecant. We will write it as cosec theta. This is equal to hypotenuse by height. Okay? This relation is like this. Now see here, sine theta was height by hypotenuse and cosec theta is hypotenuse by height. So this is exactly the inverse, you can see. So we can mention here one more relation as cosec theta equal to 1 by sine theta. Clear? Next relation will be secant. Secant we will write it as sec theta, and this one will be equal to hypotenuse. This ratio will be equal to hypotenuse by base. Okay, from this one you can see cos theta equal to base by hypotenuse, sec theta equal to hypotenuse by base. So exactly inverse. So we can write one more relation here, which will be sec theta equal to 1 by cos theta. Clear? For the last one, cotangent, we will write it as cot theta. And this one will be equal to base by height. I guess all of you understood this one, that again height by base, tan theta was, and this one is base by height. So exactly inverse. So we can write one more relation from these two. Okay. What is that? That is cot theta equal to 1 by tan theta. Clear? So these are the things you have to learn, basically basic things. These are the basic things we can say. And these relations are known as reciprocal relations. Okay? Reciprocal relations. So you can see, if you understand these three, or you if you can find out these values, you can easily find out these values. No need to calculate it again whenever we are going to do the problems, correct? Now I can tell you one thing, that is so ka twa. What is that? S for sign. Here one more relation we have written, opposite and adjacent. We will use that to remember this one. So according to this, height by hypotenuse, height means opposite obviously. So S for sine, opposite by hypotenuse. Okay. C for cos, base was adjacent. So adjacent by hypotenuse. Tan, opposite by adjacent. Clear? So in this way also you can remember the things. More relations are there in this chapter basically, but we will learn up to this, and after that we are going to do one problem, and after that we will move to the next. Clear? So these things you have to remember or memorize within yourself very clearly. So what are the important things? Right angled triangle we must have. Clear? We must have one right angled triangle. Then comes sin theta, cos theta, tan theta. These things we have to remember. Cosec theta, sec theta and cot theta. This can be derived. And these relations, reciprocal relations. And this is the remembering portion which you can use to memorize. Now we are moving for the example. Okay, we will do one example to understand this chapter more precisely. So I am going to take one triangle. Clear? So I can take this one as 3, this one 4, this one. Name it. You can easily see this one is 90 degree. Okay, I'm naming it as ABC. Now, suppose it is given that we have to find out the value of cos theta. What was the value of cos theta? Okay, we must have to mention here which one is the theta. If this one, suppose this one is the theta given in the problem, this one will be given. Okay, so cos theta will be equal to what? Base by hypotenuse. Correct? Base by hypotenuse, what will be that equal to? From here, which one is the base according to this one? This one is the base. So BC by hypotenuse is AC. Clear? So write down the values next. This one was 3, this one was 5. Now, these things are generally given in the same unit. Suppose 3 cm, 4 cm, 5 cm or meters can be mentioned. Whatever it is, this will be the lengths generally. Suppose now we have to find out the value of sine square theta. What is the value of sine square theta? Okay, here you have to remember one more thing. This is equal to sine theta whole square. Sine square theta equal to, you cannot write this one. Okay? You cannot write, not equal to. Or if this one is given, you cannot write this one. Clear? So you have to remember this one is the relation, not these things. If there is sine cube theta, it will be sine theta whole cube. Understood? These kind of relations are true, but these are not true. Okay, this you have to remember. So to find the first one, suppose sine square theta, that is equal to, what did I write previously? Sine theta square. What is the value of sine theta? Sine theta means what? Height by hypotenuse. Correct? So you write height by hypotenuse whole square. Okay. So from here you can write AB is the height according to theta by hypotenuse is AC whole square. That is equal to, put the values there, 4 by 5 I guess, yes. Then it comes 16 by 25. This one will be your answer. Suppose we are going to find out, sine theta plus cot theta. Okay, cot theta we are taking. So here, what will be sine theta? We just learnt from here AB by AC. And what will be cot theta? I think BC by AB. It will be. Okay. So after that, just put the values down. Okay. So now take the LCM. What will be the LCM? 5 and 4 will be 20. Here 16. Here 15. So it will be totally 31 by 20. This is your answer in this case. So, what we learnt after doing one problem, we have to remember this thing. This is the green signal. That means you have to remember this one. This is the red one. Don't remember. Or remember that this is not equal to. Okay. So, this is for today. We will move for the next class and the worksheets will be attached to this video maybe. Or in the school app. Thank you, class.